At Weill Cornell Medicine, I believe we have a very unique approach to treating peripheral arterial disease, or what we commonly call PAD. PAD can present in different ways in different patients. PAD is essentially the buildup of plaque in the arteries of the legs. And in some patients, this is asymptomatic and really doesn't need any interventional treatment. They just need to have risk factor modification and medical therapy. Whereas in other patients, it's essential to intervene or do a procedure to help improve their blood flow for the purpose of saving their limb. So it can really present in a range of severities, I'd say. When we talk about reducing amputation rates in patients with peripheral arterial disease, I think there's two important components to that. Early detection is certainly one point, and oftentimes early intervention with the right interventionalist or surgeon is the other part of that equation. Risk factors for PAD are common risk factors that are known for coronary disease because it's the same process of atherosclerosis or hardening of the arteries that builds up in the various blood vessels throughout the body. And these are such things as high cholesterol, diabetes, hypertension, and certainly some of the very controllable risk factors like smoking history. So those are some of the things that ultimately lead to the development of plaque in the arteries, in addition to genetics, which certainly plays an important role as well. Patients who have some of these risk factors should be on the lookout for signs and symptoms of PAD. PAD is often asymptomatic, but we don't really need to do anything interventionally or surgically, but they do need to have those risk factors controlled. On the other hand, there are some patients who ultimately develop symptoms that may or may not warrant some more aggressive treatment. One of the first symptoms that patients will develop is what we call claudication. Claudication simply means that as a patient exercises, they develop pain either in their back of their thigh or their calf muscle more commonly. Some of the more serious symptoms, on the other hand, can include sort of somewhat constant pain in their forefoot or feet. This can be due to a number of issues, but one of the more serious ones, PAD, that is so severe that it's leading to inadequate oxygen delivery to the toes to even keep the basic tissues alive. Finally, in patients who have some of these risk factors and develop a wound on their foot or area of the toe that becomes black, what we call gangrene, those are very serious signs. And those patients need to generally be treated with a procedure to improve their blood flow. Otherwise, they're at substantial risk of losing that toe or losing the limb and as a whole. We have access to a number of therapies at Weill Cornell Medicine. So I've really worked to bring some of the cutting-edge therapies to our division and therefore to our patients.